Hi guys, day two of the 2015 U.S. Open. Tennis Crier here, and I want to give a shout out to Melbourne Park for some great renovations. I will link my Australian Open map that I made a couple of years ago. I will link it below in the video, but I had made this map, and right around here, let me see if I can zero in on this, right in this area here was what was under construction a couple of years ago, and now it is the new National Tennis Center, along with 5 new plexi cushion hard courts and 8 clay courts, plus a bus park. and then the rest of this, starting with Hisense Arena, has always been there. And then you have the Grand Slam Oval, some eateries. There's the Oval, the eating, and just that's all the entertainment in purple. And there's the big courts, the show courts, and then the outer courts back here as well. Those are mostly TV courts. Those are all TV outer courts back there. So this is the new improved Melbourne Park, and they've done a great job. And there's now 13 TV courts. Like I said, you have the Hisense and then all the short show courts and then all these courts. 13. I think it was like 8 before or 7. I mean, it's insane. ESPN3 has about 40 replays if you missed anything. Galbus, huge upset to Kokkinakis. All the Australians won yesterday. It's fantastic for Australia. I have this in another video about all the injuries and the brutal tennis of today, so everybody's being more careful, but you run the risk of losing early because the depth in tennis is so strong now. Well, the Australians aren't taking this slam lightly, and they're ready to go, and they're fired up, and it's their summer, so they're in the middle of summer, these guys. They're not coming from, you know, the northern hemisphere where it's winter and people have to get revved up, like Djokovic getting sick and what have you. So, you know, yeah, the Australians are, I think this is going to be the wave of the future. We're going to see more and more people not quite as ready to go, playing exhibitions. Guys like Fognini today just, you know, he'll join us in a couple months. He lost today pretty easily. And we're going to see this a lot. Ivanovic was kind of not that way. Everybody else might have been. Ivanovic did great at Brisbane 2 weeks ago. She was ready, but they have a partial roof in Brisbane. There was no wind, and then there was conditions are different here in Melbourne, and more wind, and it was cooler temps. Brisbane was hot and humid. It was cool and dry, and it was just, you know, Rudecka is a tough opponent. These are tough. These aren't flukes. These are tough opponents for first-round matches when players are trying to get their footing in a new conditions. Even though Ivanovic, I was surprised because she did so well in Brisbane. Yes, she played in Australia a couple weeks ago, but it's still different in Melbourne. So this is something we're going to see, and we're probably going to see the Australian kids coming up strong and doing well in years to come here, along with everywhere else, but especially here. So Galbus lost to Kokkinakis. Galbus was a real threat of knocking out Nadal, I felt. Well, not now. That helps Nadal out a lot. And Nadal looks great. He's really improved his game a lot. So he takes the ball earlier, backs off the baseline, and takes big rips at service return. Service return was never his big thing. He's doing better at that. He's mixing it up a bit more. He had to change his game, and Uncle Tony did the studying. He has a great student in Rafa, and I'll tell you what, Rafa could win this. But anyway, still going to be a long road. There's going to be a lot more upsets to come. And honestly, one of the big names could win it all, or I wouldn't be surprised if it's a no-name, or somebody who's been knocking on the door for a while like Berdych. So anything could happen, anything. A lot of it will be also how people hang in there physically, obviously. Okay.